A little bit of
Celine Dion.
She is such a chameleon in terms of her voice, because she always sounds so different to me in every song she does.
That is Surprise Surprise off of her new Taking Chances.
And today is Saturday, December 1st, 2007. And
World AIDS Day.
World AIDS Day. And the reason, and how many days is it?
1 year, 1 month, and 19 days until GWB is out of here.
So why did you play Surprise Surprise?
Oh, well, last night we came up here to Philadelphia, or yesterday we came here, and last night we went and surprised Monty. It was her 30th birthday, and it was a lot of fun.
It was fun.
We hung out and surprised her, and I think she knew a little bit, but it was still great fun. We got to catch up with a lot of people and meet a lot of new people, and great fun.
Yeah, it was really nice. I think at first it was so awkward when she walked into the room, but then she had a really good time, and she was very sociable. I thought she made a great party host or guest.
Yeah.
Because she was enjoying herself and going around and visiting with all of her family and friends.
She was a social butterfly.
She was
going
a social butterfly. If
group to group to group to group.
And she was thrilled that you were there.
Yeah, she was. It was great fun seeing her.
It is very nice.
I gave her a picture from when we were little kids.
Yeah, and then you also got her 2 seasons of Will and Grace. Why?
Because she said, well, we're like Will and Grace, so.
Yeah.
That's our always. There for a while we used to call each other and we'd leave messages and we'd say, call Grace. Call Will.
Yeah. You know, there are so many of those kinds of relationships between gay men and women that are so close and so, you know, so different, I would think, than
like
other kinds
almost.
Of... Yeah, right. It's very interesting how that is. Those relationships are. They're wonderful relationships. Anyway, to Monty, happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Holla! Oh, and we also got to see
Maura and Anna.
And Anna. Yeah, they were
good to see them.
They were so cute. They're such nice kids.
Yeah.
They had this up at a Knights of Columbus Hall up in Northeast Philadelphia. And it's a bit of a trip for me because it's a trip back in my time. Because I grew up in Philadelphia, outside of Philadelphia. My grandmother lived very close to where this Knights of Columbus Hall was. So it was kind of strange to drive out there. And we are in Center City, Philadelphia. We're at 12th and Market.
Right there.
At, in Center City, Philadelphia. In fact, we're literally a block from Center City, from the
City Hall
where William Penn stands atop. So it's kind of fun. So we're going to...
the market is right down there.
The Reading Terminal Market is over here. This used to be, in fact, when I was a kid, we would come in from the suburbs by rail. There was a lot of rail lines that came in, and they would all converge on this Reading Terminal. And it is now a convention center. They've remodeled it, etc. But below it is an old kind of like a produce market or a food
Farmer's market.
Farmer's market would be a better way to describe it. And
like a Pike's Place, or, you know, they showed pictures in there of all the different
markets
that were, you know, that same kind of feeling, and it was cool to see that. I thought that was really neat.
Yeah, if we get a chance, we'll take some video, because also there's a lot of Amish people represented there, so there's a lot of Pennsylvania Dutch food, a lot of Italian food.
Oh, it all looks so good, the breads, the cheeses. Saw, like, prawns that were, like, that big. They were huge.
Yeah, the seafood was good.
And the produce was all, like, bountiful and...
Yeah.
Great.
It's just really kind of funny, though, because for, I guess, maybe 6 years, I lived about 5 blocks down the street from here and was Poe. I was a Poe boy. And we used to come down to that market to try to get bargains. My partner Danny and I, who live together here, which I think fondly of today on World AIDS Day, because I unfortunately lost him to AIDS back in 1988, but... it's kind of nice reminiscing and thinking about him.
to Danny. We need to give Danny a holler.
But I showed you where we used to live.
That's right.
Gave you a little tour.
We'll try to get some video up in the next couple of days of the party and going around. We're going to go see your sister today.
Yeah.
It's your sister and Tom.
And my new brother-in-law. They got married this year sometime. And they're going to drive down. They live up in the suburbs of Philadelphia.
It'll be good to see them.
It will be good to see them. We'll have lunch with them.
That'll be great.
And we're kind of hoping that tonight we might... Drowsy Chaperone is touring through, and it's at this the beautiful Academy of Music here in Philadelphia. So we're going to attempt to see if we can get tickets. We don't know if we can. Cross your fingers for us.
I don't want to show off no more. I don't want to change keys no more.
Are you going to be able to sing the whole score tonight, huh?
Well, I know some of them.
We got a email from the Kevin Miller.
Oh, right.
And we do, seriously, we encourage people to go to thekevinmiller.com. This goes back to my point about broadband.
It's here.
It's here. Because you can find incredibly entertaining things on the broadband. There are four, I'm assuming... Two of them claim to be heterosexual. One has a wife, so I'm going to assume that there's proof there. Two of the fellas I don't know, but they are singing. They're lip syncing to 98 Degrees.
Oh yeah, that wasn't on there. That was.
Oh, we got to get the link to that then.
Oh, I'll put it up then. I'll put that up.
But the Kevin Miller, his site is funny. If you get a chance, go check it out. He's
and if you know him, he's requesting something for everyone. So go there, check it out.
Oh yeah, he's got a shameless plug. Go to Kevin Miller is one of these people that I love to death, and he is as odd as I love him. He is just the oddest human being I think I've ever met. He probably will take that as a compliment.
Can I tell everyone what I read? Well, before we left Orlando, it may not be a national story, but. There is a Palm Bay mayor, the mayor of Palm Bay, wants to ban all products from China. And I think, okay, well, that sounds great on paper. But if you look at everything, you know, all the technology that you have in your house and all the lamps and, you know, like, I could go on and on and on. Everything, if you look on the bottom of it, has made in China. So, good luck getting everything out of China, out of your town.
They kind of, they reneged on that slightly, and they said...
Oh, they did?
Yeah, the outcome was, for basically to your point, how can they do that? But what they decided to do is kind of create a pro-buy American kind of policy in their town. So that if they could, they were going to attempt to buy American, which I think is... That's a good idea.
Yeah, it's a good idea, but I don't know. It's just that whole thing of, oh, we're going to ban everything from China. Oh, well, yeah, that's impossible.
Yeah, but don't you think there is some issues with the fact that we import so much and export probably so little? No wonder the dollar is so weak. We're weak against all of the other nations around the world. I wonder
if
we're
not. Yeah, we've really gone down in the...
And we need jobs. We need people to be able to make products here that we can...
Export out to other countries. So
or sell ourselves, one or the other. Keep the money in the U.S.
That too.
I don't know. There's many ways of looking at that. I mean, if it wasn't for international investment at this point, places, many, many third world countries wouldn't get a chance. So I guess there's a good thing there. Although you look at what's going on over at the United Arab Emirates in Dubai, and that's kind of amazing.
All right.
Real quickly before we rush off, because we'll do another vlog, but since it is World AIDS Day, I did want to kind of, I did think about Danny, and it does bring to mind that it still is a really devastating disease that is preventable, and I worry that a lot of the younger generation's not thinking about it and not practicing safer sex. When you, there's a lot of talk on the internet, and even when you see things on the internet, particularly in chat rooms and all, there's a lot of young people that are not practicing safe sex, and it's a very dangerous disease, and I hope a lot of people do remind each other to take care of each other in that way.
We're all we've got.
Yeah. What else? Where are we at time-wise?
We're at 10 minutes we've got left. 10 seconds. So I'm going to leave us with snow, because it could possibly snow here.
Snow! Snow!